Hello everyone, welcome back. Finally, I have brought a complete case study for you all in which we have done the whole branding, made the homepage, and also did the whole website live. In the middle of this class, I have also told you the URL of the website which we have done live, so you can explore it from there. And definitely it will be very useful for you because it is a real project, so I will share the whole case study with you, and we will also make the whole design in Figma. So without any further delay, let's get into the classroom. So first of all, I would like to tell you its concept. What does Wari do and why is its name Wari? So basically, Wari is a website of an artist where artists can sell their paintings. So here, the first interesting thing is that I want to discuss with you, I want to present. So the logo we have made, the whole concept of branding we have done, I will tell you. And I will discuss with you all the problems that have come in the layout, in which format it has been made, and we will also see it here. So first of all, I will open the interesting part of it, the branding of Wari that we have done here. So if I open Wari, then in the first slide, we will tell you why Wari. So Wari is the name of a journey that is done in Maharashtra in the honor of Lord Vithoba. So Lord Vithoba is the form of Lord Vishnu, and this is how this vaccine is applied. I will give you one more additional information. The Google Map icon has also been taken from here. And let's move forward in this. So what did we propose to them? Here you can also read the concept note. Some principles have also been applied, and if you look here, then the Hindi word is Re-Ra, and there is a quantity in which we are depicting the vaccine of Lord Vithoba. And here if you look at W, then we have applied a law here, which is foreground figure. So here if you look at the deep level, then you will see three more shapes inside W. So what do these three shapes depict? Basically artistic shapes, and here we have also masked an art piece in it. So we gave this kind of concept. And if you look at the next concept, then here we have made W a little modern and given a simple logo. But I will define you a little more in this. This is Lord Vithoba's vaccine, but we have modernized it a little and tried to tell that a lot of people are going towards a destination, that is, a journey is taking place. So this was the concept here, and we did the same in the third one, but we tried to make it an iconic logo. This is the branding part, and finally we use this logo, but there were some iterations in it, and after the iteration we have finally made this one. And after that we come to the website, how we have made the website, which technology we have used, and one more thing for you, that this website is live. You can see it, warrior.com. Now let me tell you a little background of this. Basically we have designed it in WordPress. It is made on WordPress theme, and it is a dynamic website. So here we have designed a homepage, and some inner pages are also designed, so you can refer the inner pages. If you are interested in seeing the online website, then you can see there too. So here in Figma, I tell you the technical things, whatever the complex part is. As we always do in a layout, so here I took a grid system. You can take any desktop size, and the grid system which I took was 12 column and 5 column. I will tell you why I took 5 column and 12 column. So if I activate 12 column, then you will see that I have made this layout on a fixed area, and your navigation will be fluid. So here if I see the navigation, I have made it in the same way as I tell you every time, and I will give you a little tip in this, how exactly it is made. So I take a rectangle from here. Let's just design the navigation. We are not doing much in this. You can place the logo here. As you can have any brand, then we have to make here, home and about. Let's repeat this also because we want to know a simple logic, how it is made. So if I place all the navigation randomly like this and select all, I selected all of them and I press Shift A. So this is our auto layout from here. I can maintain all my padding. Here this navigation is done, and same with these icons. These are also managed from auto layout. If you see, they are also managed in this way, and we have just made a little drop shadow here. We have made this box drop shadow in effect. So here this area is finished, and we have bifurcated it in 50-50%. My idea was that our banner part will be fluid, that is, it will be made on fixed resolution. So here this website is running online, and after being developed, It looks like this, so here you must be able to understand what kind of planning we have, that our banner will be fit to screen. That is, it will cover the whole above the fold. So this was our online website, and here we took a box in 50% and masked an image in it, and here we have put two basic arrows. If you find a new thing here, then I will tell you one thing, that if you see any theme, then there will be an icon here and there will be an arrow here. In this way, two arrows are put here on every website. But the uniqueness here is that both are near each other. So what is the benefit of this? We have applied Fitz's law here. If you want to go to this banner, then you will click on it immediately. If you want to go here, then you will click immediately. So here, your distance is decreasing to reach your target. So here we have also applied Fitz's law. And here one more special thing, I always say that we should use limited fonts. And to use limited fonts, I have used only two fonts here. One is Playfair Display. I have paired the fonts here. One is sans serif and the other is serif. So here you will see the second one is Montserrat. So I have played with these two fonts on the whole website. And here, to bring a little premiumness, there are very fine things that I am discussing with you. To bring premiumness, I have also opened a little character spacing here. And here I have made three dots to depict the number of banners we are giving here. And I had made a custom shape. We had masked it inside. We have also masked the same graphic that we have put in the logo. So this was the idea of a whole banner part, that how to make a banner part. Now let's come to our main part, our collection. So I have shown the collection and categories here, that we deal in painting, also in photography, collage, sculpture, drawing. I have shown this through icons. And all these icons are custom. And I have also picked some, but all have been made consistent. If you see, I can select all the icons and reduce their thickness at once. You will see that it is with an equal weightage. There are limited objects in it. And I have made this custom here. And below this, you will also see that I have opened the word spacing of the content. Whenever you are making something premium, then keep the font small, and if you open the character spacing of it, then it looks very nice. Now, if I talk about hover, then I had planned hover here, that how will hover be? So I just reversed it on black. Now how was it made? For this also I used a grid system. So first I took a 12 and I took 5 for this. So in 5 column, you will make a box, a line and align your things. It is not very complicated, that's why I am not making it and showing you. Then what's new? If we come to what's new section, then simple image is kept, and I have reused these arrows. Outside the image, I have put a line of 1 pixel. Now how? I have put it in a very simple way. I will tell you how I have put it. So I have taken this image from here. Only image is masked and nothing else. I have pressed Shift A. And after pressing Shift A, if you see here, then you can open the space from both sides. I open my space and press Shift X, which switched my fill and stroke and made it white. So this is how I made this line. And if you see the hover effect, I didn't do anything in hover effect, just put a text on a black overlay and a button with premiumness and same font style. And below we have given about worry. What does worry do? First it gives a headline, then a description, and then read more. So if you show all the text here, it won't look good, and we have given an image. Basically, it is a placeholder. The image can be changed here. As I said, this is a dynamic website. Below, we have given another section, which is our premium collections, and we have shown it in this way. And we have made a hover effect of this, in which if you hover then in the center, this content will come with premiumness with white patch. So this hover has been made here. And if you want to see all this, we have made a different page of the view all collection. If I talk about testimonial, then we have made testimonial very simple. I have told testimonial many times in my layouts. I have also made a separate class. How can we make it? We can make it through auto layout. So there is nothing. There is simple text. There is an image. And here I have played with a little font. That's it. I haven't done anything else. And the grid that we have opened here, we will make it 12 for now. 5 was only for this. And 12 we can measure here with 12. And again, I have not done anything below, I have only given text, and our patch is running similar. For consistency, we have made hover effect like this, and here we have put three images of events. All our events, we will cover all of them in this. And after clicking on view, all there will be a page of dedicated event. The page of blog is also similar. In the same way, functionality will work. Then we have put a feature of Instagram. Real feeds of Instagram will come here. And here it will show you how many likes are there on which image and how many comments are there. So you don't need to go to Instagram, you will get this information here. And if you want to go to Instagram, then there will be a trigger here. So you can land it from there on your Instagram account. Then we have made this long page, but we have provided provision of back to top below. So you can experience the layout. Then we say that now you can go back to top. We have given a simple category and subcategories based on the grid system. And normally we have shown our primary link like this. And we have also given the copyright text. So basically, after repeating the logo again, we will also add a little text about it. So with this ideation, we have made the whole concept. Scanner pages are also made. And as I said, it is made on WordPress. So there are limitations there. So I will recommend that whenever you make any website for WordPress, you choose a theme and keep the placeholder structure of the design the same. You can change your design a little. And do tell in the comment that how did you like this branding concept and website concept. I will feel very good if you comment and tell me. So that's all in today's class. Now I want to know from you that how did you like the class? Do tell me in the comment. And if you like this class, which you always like, then please subscribe to the channel and share as much as you can.